Hey StoneBridge kids, we're excited that you guys are worshiping with us this morning. As we start to worship together, I wanted to start by just reading a verse from Psalm for you. So this is Psalm 28, and this is verse 7, and King David is writing this song and psalm, and here's what he says in verse 7. He says, "The Lord is my strength and my shield. My heart trusts in him, and I am helped. Therefore, my heart celebrates, and I give thanks to him with my song." So David's saying that God is his strength and is his shield. God is what protects him, what takes care of him, what gets him through the day. And David says, when my heart trusts in him, when I place my trust in God, and when I put my dependence on God, I am helped. Then God helps me. He answers my prayers. He hears my prayers to him, and I'm helped. So when we put our trust in God, when we look to him to provide for us and to take care of us and to know what's best, rather than putting our trust in ourselves, our own abilities, or how good at basketball we are, what our score on our math test was, how good or bad our day is going, when we look to God to care for us instead of those things, then our heart, then we're helped by God. We put ourselves in a place to receive his love and his care, and the good plans that he has for us. And then David says, therefore my heart celebrates, because I've chosen to trust God and because I've seen his goodness as I depend on him, my heart is happy. One of the translations I read of that said, my heart jumps for joy, and I give thanks to him with my song. And so I praise him through worship. I sing about the things that he's done. I thank him for who he is. And so that's what I want us to do this morning. We're going to worship, we're going to sing and praise and thank God for the things that he's done. We're going to ask God to remind us where our help comes from and to place our trust in him. And we want to remember all of the times that we have placed our trust in him, where we have trusted and depended on the Lord, and we've seen him come through, and we've seen him be our strength and our shield. So let's pray, and then we're going to step into worship. God, we love you so much, and we thank you that you are our strength, that you are our shield, and that we don't have to take care of ourselves, God. We don't have to have it all figured out. We don't have to be the best. We don't have to have all the answers. That we get to just look to you, and we get to trust and depend that you will lead us, that you have a plan for us, that you have a plan for your kingdom here on earth, God. And so this morning, as we worship, I pray you would just remind each of us of times where we have looked to you and placed our trust in you, and where we've seen you come through, where we've seen your goodness, where we've seen your love and your care for us and for your people, God. And if there's anywhere in our lives right now where we are not putting our trust in you, God, where we're experiencing worry or fear or anger because we are trying to make things happen for ourselves, or we're looking to our own strength, God, would you just bring those to the surface of our hearts, God? Would you help us to see where we need to trust you more, Lord, and just give us the courage and the strength that we need to do that, God, because we know you are good, and we know that we'll see your goodness when we put ourselves in a place to receive it from you. So Lord, again, we just thank you this morning for who you are. We want to praise you with our song. We want to praise you with our singing and our words. This morning. We love you so much. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, wherever you are, you can stand and join us for worship.
Come, who run to him in faith. was lost, but he brought me in. Oh, his love for me. Oh, his love for me. Who the sun sets free. Oh, is free.
Awesome. Thanks for worshiping with us this morning. Mr. Luke is here today with our scripture, so I'm going to invite him up and we're going to hear from him.
All right, awesome. Glad to be here again. Thank you, Katie. This week, we're going to be talking about a lot of stuff. We're going to be talking about Paul. We'll be talking about gifts. We'll be talking about music. We'll be talking about faith. So I'm excited to get started. So let's get on into it. We'll start today with our memory verse that we've been working on this month. If you remember, it's Ephesians chapter 2, verse 8. And what that says is, God's grace has saved you because of your faith in Christ. Your salvation doesn't come from anything you do. It's God's gift. And so that's our memory verse for this month. We'll be using that, we'll be thinking about that as we talk about, you know, the things that we have been talking about and what we will talk about. So just to recap from last week, Tracy was talking a lot about the gifts that we receive, and the biggest gift of all that we receive from God, that is salvation, that is free to us, no cost at all. I'm excited to get started. So let's get into it. I'd like to start today by talking about music. We don't know each other very well yet. We'll get to know each other a little bit better, but I love music. That's just something about me. I like to listen to music. I love to play music. I'm a drummer. And I also like to dance to music, though who knows if it's very good. It's not very good. But yeah, I like all types of music. I like classic rock. I like rap. I like some pop. I like funk. But I think most of all, what I grew up listening to because of my parents and what I just love listening to is disco music. Now, you may not know anything about disco other than this dance move. This dance move right here. But let me tell you, I love disco. It's made for dancing. And my favorite disco band, they're called Earth, Wind & Fire. Now, Earth, Wind & Fire is from a long time ago. They weren't big when I was alive. They weren't big when any of you were alive. They were actually really big in like 1979, 1980, that 10 years around that. That's when my dad was in high school. So we're talking about a while ago. So I think you may not have heard their music. You might have. So I just was gonna play a song real quick for you guys. This is one of their most famous songs. This is called September. You may have heard this. It's in such films as Night at the Museum, which came out when I was growing up, but I think it's also in the last Trolls movie. So this is that song. Let's just give a little listen. So that is that song. Hard not to dance to that song. But yeah, that's the music I like to listen to. That's my favorite band. That's one of my favorite songs. And you know what the cool thing about music is? You can share it with everybody around you. In fact, it's better when you share it with the people around you. For instance, it'd be downright embarrassing to dance by yourself. Just embarrassing and weird to just dance by yourself all alone in a room. But yeah, we can share it with others. I like to share my favorite music with others. I like to tell them what's good about it. I like to point out things like, hey, listen to that drum beat or listen to the lyrics there. They're not even saying words, they're just making sounds. But I like to share what I care about with others. And a lot of people do that. A lot of people do that in the Bible too. Somebody who's very famous for doing that is Paul. And so we're gonna talk about Paul now. But first, let me give you a quick recap on Paul. Paul was a Roman soldier who Jesus appeared to. Jesus blinded Paul. Paul was healed 3 days later. And then Paul, for the rest of his life, all he did was travel around sharing the word of God with all these different churches and all these different people across the world. So now that we've caught back up on Paul, you guys know Paul, you guys know everything there is to know about Paul. Let's talk about him a little bit more. This comes from chapter 17 in the book of Acts when he's in Athens, which is in Greece. So Paul is in Athens and he's waiting for Timothy and other people to join him. So he starts walking around Athens. And in Athens, there's a bunch of statues for gods other than our own gods. So false gods, idols, there's statues, there's temples. And Paul does not like this at all. So what does he do? He goes down to the Jewish synagogue and he starts preaching and telling others about the word of God, what he's heard, what he's seen. And so, you know, this is kind of a big thing. And the town council is like, we don't know what's going on. Let's get Paul in here. So the town council, that's called the Areopagus. It's this group of thinkers and lawmakers that say, we want to hear what he's saying. So they bring him in and they start asking him. They're saying, what are you guys talking about? What are you talking about, Paul? And Paul basically just starts sharing the word of the Lord and sharing the gospel with his people. And this is what he says. I wanted to read it straight from the good book itself. So let me pull it up. This is Acts chapter 17, starting with verse 24. This is what Paul told the Areopagus, the group of leaders in Athens. He said, he is the God who made the world. He also made everything in it. He is the Lord of heaven and earth. He doesn't live in temples built by hands. He is not served by human hands. He doesn't need anything. He himself gives life and breath to all people. He also gives them everything else they have. From one man, he made all the people of the world. Now they live all over the earth. He decided exactly when they should live, and he decided exactly where they should live. God did this so that people would seek him. Then perhaps they would reach out for him and find him. They would find him even though he's not far from any of us. In him we live and move and exist. As some of our own poets have also said, we are his children. So Paul tells us to the council, and he tells them we're all God's children. We're all created by him. We all live because of him, and he doesn't need anything from us, but he will give us salvation. That is what Paul tells the council. And you know, some people, they don't believe it, and they make fun of him. But a lot of people, a couple people, they hear what Paul's saying, they see Paul, how he's living, and they begin to believe in God and put their trust in God. So that's the Bible story for today. And to move on from that, if you remember last week, Tracy talked a lot about how we get the gift of God. The only thing we have to do is put our faith in him. And if you remember what faith is, we've talked about this before, faith is putting your trust in something you can't see because of what you can see. And so the people, they saw Paul, saw how he was living, they put their trust in him, and they have faith in God. And so that was a lot of stuff we talked about last week, talking about this week. So this week we're talking about how you can share your faith with other people. That's one of the best things about God's gift. And I know when I say sharing, you immediately think, oh, not a big fan of sharing. That's something that my parents tell me to do. That's something my teachers tell me to do. And it's something that a lot of times means I get less of something I want. If I share my snack with somebody, if I share my toy or video game with somebody, then that's less I get from me. But that's not the case for this gift from God. God's gift is never ending, never ceasing. There's enough to go around for everybody for all time, unlimited. So that's pretty cool. Now, if we can move on to how do we share that gift with everybody, right? We know we can, we know it won't mean we get any less, but how can we share? And so I think we can basically just look to what Paul did in this part of while he was in Athens. What did he do? He told people. He told people he had his faith in God. He told people he trusted in God. And then he told them more and more and more. He told them that he created heaven and earth. He told them that he created all of us out of one person. He said he knew where they would live and when they would live. He just told them everything he knew. He told them his testimony. And because of his testimony, these people saw that and became believers. Now, that can be scary. That can be uncomfortable. Others can make fun of us. They made fun of Paul. So how do we get past that? Well, what I do to when I share the word of God and the gospel with people is I think of how I talk about other things in my life that I like. And you can do that too. Don't you love sharing with other people what you like? Think of if you saw Hamilton recently, or Frozen 2, or the last time you watched Georgia play Georgia Tech in football. You want to share that with all your friends at school or maybe family members who didn't see that game or those movies or that play because it's exciting to you and they're excited by what you like. That's why I spent probably too long telling you guys about disco and Earth, Wind & Fire and my favorite song, September, because I like to share about the things that I like. I love to share about the things that I love. I love to share about the things that are important to me. And the great thing about God is that he is the most important thing in our lives. And his gift is the most important thing in our lives. So we should share that with other people. That means talk about God like you talk about movies or music. Talk about how you love what he's done in your life, what he's done for other people you know. Like you talk about how Georgia crushed Georgia Tech last season. Because we can all have a big impact on those around us that we love and we care about when we share with them the gift that God has given us so freely. I appreciate y'all listening to Earth, Wind, and Fire with me, talking about Paul with me. And I'd love to pray to end this and our time together today. God, I just want to say thank you. in all the strife and weird times we have right now, I just want to say thank you for the ability to communicate virtually with everybody, to communicate in person with some safely. I want to ask you to have your hand in all that we do and all that the kids do. I want to thank you for giving us a gift that we can share with everybody we know, everybody we love, that doesn't run out, that doesn't grow less because more people have it. I want to thank you for the things that you have done in each and everybody's life who's watching this video. Everything you will do, everything you will do, and the people that they share your word with. I want to thank you for giving us people like Paul, who will share the gospel and teach us and show us the way. I just want to say thank you, and we praise you. Amen. All right, well, that's it for me this week. Had a great time talking to y'all. I hope to see y'all soon, either virtually, in person. Anyway, have a great week.